in the past, couple of decades, the research has seemed to shown that, limiting these certain macronutrients, protein, fat, carbohydrates, you sort of tweak the amount that you take in, you can alter the way an animal ages, at least in terms of the way their tissues are aging. Not necessarily going to, increase their maximum lifespan,
Yes.
but you may increase their average lifespan, which is.
Yes. I think we, in the last 20 years, we've learned a lot. And a lot of this research has been actually causing a reevaluation of some of the public policies that have been enacted in the last 20 and 30 years in terms of what should you eat, when should you eat. So a lot of work is ongoing today and actually generating lots of really interesting data. Along with this, the basic science of aging, I think what people have studied is trying to understand what are the pathways that control aging in C. elegans, in Drosophila, the fruit flies, in the little nematode, or in mice. One of the major pathways that has emerged is the insulin signaling pathway. That was the work of Cynthia Kenyon back in the 1990s, showing that the insulin signaling pathway is one of the major pathways that controls aging. Well, if you know this, you can already sort of backtrack and say, well, what does insulin do? It's the major hormone that allows you to utilize carbohydrates. And so the implication of this is the more carbohydrate you eat, the more you activate the insulin signaling pathway. And the prediction would be that the faster you age. And I think real data really suggests this model. Now, it flies completely in the face of what we've assumed to be correct. You can walk into any store and find low-fat diet and low-fat products. Turns out that we really believe that the culprit is more carbohydrates. And the recent paper just came out, which is really remarkable, showing, analyzing in thousands of humans, a fraction of their total calorie intake that is represented by carbohydrates. And they were able to, so just by interviewing them and asking, what do you eat? And what they showed in this paper is the all-cause mortality was directly correlated to the amount of carbohydrate that one eats. So the people who ate the least amount of carbohydrate showed the lowest all-cause mortality.
Wow.
And
Did they differentiate between refined carbohydrates and, for example, vegetables, which are carbohydrates?
they did. They didn't. And I think, this is obviously not all carbohydrates are created equal, but I think
Possibly a confounder, though.
irrespective, total carbohydrate was a very strong predictor.
Wow. Yeah.
But obviously, if your total carbohydrate intake is, it's very hard to eat a high amount of carbohydrates that are all sort of a low absorption type of carbohydrate. So typically, the people who eat a lot of carbohydrate will eat a lot of the bad ones as
Right.
well.
Yeah, most people that are eating that are probably eating more of a standard sort of American diet, where it's chips and crackers and cookies. And I think people that are following more like of a Paleolithic type of diet, where they're eating, whole foods and meat and
Yes.
nuts, and probably would eat their carbohydrate intake, the bulk would be from vegetables and
Absolutely.
things like that.